Thank you. Beware, stranger. The dead walk the crest. The dead aren't supposed to walk around, and they certainly aren't supposed to attack innocent loggers. The dead emerged from bone-strewn barrow. I was working when it started. I buried my axe in three of them, but they kept on coming. My family's still out. Can you check on my family? We have three logging cabins scattered around the bone-strewn crest. Look for my brother, my cousin, and my wife. I can sneak around, but I can't fight Draugr in this state. Please, make sure my family is all right.
Please, you have to help me. please help me. I pushed her down, and now she's gone. It was the only way I could get away from those horrible monsters. We were on our way back to Windhelm. We decided to take a shortcut, and they were everywhere, all around us. There were so many of them. I need to go. I need to get out of here. Those things are everywhere. Please, my friend may still be alive. If you see her, you need to save her. We were near the center of the hot springs when we were attacked. I pushed Imhe down. It was the only thing I could do to get away. I wasn't thinking. I never meant to hurt her. Please, find Imhe. I need to go.
Yeah. brûle les temples.
Stay away from me, you monster!
Damn it, woman! Scales here is about to have a really bad day if she doesn't come with me right now. That bite, it's spreading faster than she realizes. These creatures are the twisted offspring of a vampire, and their bite is just as dangerous. Once bitten, the curse seeps into your body. It gets into your blood until the fever takes you. Then the craving comes over you. The craving for blood. There may be a way. I need to get her back to my manor, though. If she stays out here too long, the sun will find her. Then she'll experience a pain like she has never felt before. Right now, she just needs to shut up and listen to me. I'm just like the creatures that attacked her, except my mind is my own, and I'm a little more sensitive to sunlight. Now, before you do something we'll both regret, hear me out. If I'm going to save Scales, I'm going to need your help. I need Blood Fiend dust. You can get it from the creatures that bit her. Then maybe we can reverse the effects and save Scales here. I'll keep her safe in the meantime. If you can get that dust, bring it to my manor. Time to go, Scales. We need to make sure you don't turn into one of these creatures.
What are you doing? No, don't let it take me.
Big man said you'd be showing up soon. He's upstairs with the lizard girl.
Scales tried to escape, so we locked her up. Nothing to worry about. Just want to make sure everyone stays safe. It won't be long before she gets that crazed look in her eyes, though. You saw those things out there. They're mindless monsters. As ugly as they are evil, and only interested in killing and feasting. Do you really want Scales out there attacking people? No? That's why I put her in a cage. There's a chance, but it's just that, a chance. There's no guarantee she'll survive the process. I've seen it kill as often as it cures. It's a risk, but the alternative is far, far worse. You've made the right decision. I promise I'll do everything in my power to help her. We'll watch over her. If she doesn't improve, we'll make sure she doesn't succumb to the bloodlust. Believe me, you won't regret this. Poor Scales burns with the blood fever. She'll be trying to eat every face she sees soon enough. Who would wish that fate upon her? Well, I suppose my father would, but you'll learn more about him shortly. I promise we'll look after Scales. We'll make sure that she's safe and that she doesn't hurt anyone. Now, I need your help. You saw for yourself. Vampire abominations prowl the springs. Those are my father's toys, sick creations of his evil mind. We've all been infected, cursed, plagued. Call it what you will, we're vampires. But we don't have to succumb to the curse's savage nature. My father thinks otherwise. He believes we should embrace the bloodlust, the power, taking those who can't oppose us and making them our own. As civil war rages through Eastmarch, he feels the time is right to strike. He wants to grow an army of undead before anyone notices. My father must be stopped at all costs. He's already targeted the Winterland Hunters. He's about to turn them into his puppets. Jaruk downstairs can tell you how to save them. That's our first step. We turn my father into dust, and end his tyranny once and for all. The Hunters are merely a distraction. If we deny him their blood, he'll grow curious, perhaps even vulnerable. He'll want to know who interfered with his plans. This world is a deadly place, when the sun glows bright in the sky. It's just too dangerous outside. Even the wounds I recently suffered require time and a great deal of blood to overcome. Imagine the cost of trying to deal with all those hunters. I must say you are a strange one. Others would have drawn weapons the moment they saw what I was. Anyway, I could attempt to scare them away, but they're hunters. I don't suspect they scare very easily.
We turn my father into dust, and end this tyranny once and for all. The hunters are merely a distraction. If we deny him their blood, he'll grow curious, perhaps even vulnerable. He'll want to know who interfered with his plans.
I hope Valeric didn't convince you to join our cause. Our battles never end well. True, his father's a bastard, but he's a strong bastard. Valeric can't beat him, and those who help us usually die. But enough depressing talk. How can Juruk help you? Ah, yes, many times. Each time, things have gone horribly wrong. It usually ends up very messy. Lots of blood. But don't worry about it. Everything will be different this time. Yes, yes, Juruk always has a plan. The blood fiends hunt by scent. They have the hunter's scent and await the command to strike. If we mask the scent, the blood fiends will lose interest and wander off. The hunters will be saved. Take this liquid. It is a gift from Jaruk's close friends, Cello and Harp. Don't ask what it is. You don't want to know. Splash it on the hunters. Make them smell like something the blood fiends won't want to eat. Oh, they'll hate it. They'll probably try to kill you. It's best if you rough them up a bit first. Show them who's stronger. Then splash it in their faces. As long as they end up very smelly, the hunters should be safe.
Majorn, my master. You've made contact with Majorn's son, Valeric. He's a troubled young man, ashamed of his heritage. Majorn simply wishes to end the conflict with his son. For this reason, my lord requests to meet with you.